And welcome to Trading Nation. I'm Brian Sullivan. And as always, we are joined by CNBC contributor Helima Croft, global head of commodity strategy at RBC Capital Markets in her day job. And Helima, we've seen a little bit in oil. It's been firm. Are all eyes going to be on October 12th when the president will talk about Iran? And what happens if they decertify the Obama administration's Iran deal?
Well, if he decertifies it, it immediately goes to Congress. And then Congress has a 60-day window to bring back sanctions in an expedited manner. It'll be a filibuster-proof process. The market, I think, will be concerned that we could get a return of the sanctions that required importing countries to make significant reductions in their Iranian crude imports every 6 months, and which barred foreign firms from investing in the Iranian upstream sector. So it's a very significant development that could happen next week.
And if the president takes an especially hard line on tone on Iran, forget about even the decertification. If he gets very sort of aggressive with Iran, would you expect a spike in oil prices?
I mean, I think you could see on that day prices move higher. I think to really move significantly higher, what we'd really need to see is clear indications of sanctions are coming back. Because right now, there's a view out there, if the U.S. just goes it alone on sanctions, it won't matter. And what I keep saying is, what matters is how much does the United States government, and the White House in particular, want to force foreign firms out of Iran. If they want to force them out, they can always threaten to lock them out of U.S. capital markets, and that's a pretty big stick.
What's then the variable? What's then, we know the oil market is always, Helima, push-pull, right?
Yes.
We're producing too much, but don't worry, demand goes up. Oh, there's hardline words over here, but Nigeria is cheating. What would be the counterbalance to that?
I mean, the counterbalance is sort of the bullish story which we have in terms of very good global demand, inventories being drawn down, and these geopolitical stories we're watching this week. I think the big thing on the other side of that is U.S. producer hedging. That is the iceberg for the oil market, because once WTI is comfortably over 50, you have producers coming in hedging their production. And we look like we have some room to run where U.S. producers could hedge more going into 18.
Are we the swing producer, the United States, or does Saudi Arabia still have market moving power?
I mean, Saudi Arabia absolutely still has market moving power, especially with their new best friend, Russia. So when you combine those two sovereign oil heavyweights, if they are in it to win it and keep the deal going to the end of 2018, I think that is meaningful for the market. I mean, what could be very bearish if Saudi and Russia break up and they basically decide to go max out in production? I don't think that's going to happen. But if Saudi and Russia want to continue to manage this market, that does put a floor under prices.
So what do you believe is going to be the oil story for the next 3 to 6 to 12 months? Is it Iran? Is it Saudi Arabia? Is it America? Is it something else?
I think in terms of like the geopolitical stories, you're going to be watching Iran. I think Venezuela is something that's off people's radars, but it's a clear and present danger. $3.5 billion that national oil company owes over the next 2 months. If they default, that oil company effectively shuts down. That's 2 million barrels of production. Watch Venezuela and watch what happens with IPO of Saudi Aramco. We think that very much anchors the Saudi oil policy. But again, on the other side of it, you need to watch the U.S. producers and what they do with hedging and what does U.S. production look like.
Helima Croft, RBC, it's always a pleasure to get your views. A lot of stuff going on, as always, geopolitically, Iran, Saudi Arabia, and everything else. Thank you, Helima.
Thank you so much.
Of course. And thank you all for tuning into Trading Nation. We'll see you next time. Take care.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.